Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we shall discuss the working of automatic frequency control. We shall also describe the working of a typical transmitter with an AFC system. Before we go into our topic for today, we shall have a short revisit on few points which we have already discussed in the last classes. This will help us to understand the need for an AFC system in a transmitter. In the last classes, we have seen two different techniques of generating FM waves by using direct methods. The first one, what we saw, was the reactance modulator circuit for generating FM, and the other was the varector diode modulator. Now, if we look into the reactance modulator circuit, what we have studied, we know that this modulator circuit is used along with a Hartley or a clap oscillator. We connect it to the tank circuit. We connect this reactance modulator across the tank circuit of a Hartley or a clap oscillator. So what we observe here is that the disadvantage of this particular circuit is that since we are using LC oscillators as the master oscillators for these FM modulators, we find that these oscillators or these FM modulators are not quite stable. So that is the limitation of this reactance modulator. So this is where actually this automatic frequency control systems are required. So if you have but this reactance modulator has got the advantage that it has got good frequency deviation. So we can exploit the advantage of reactance modulator, but the disadvantage has to be curtailed or it has to be controlled in some manner. So this is where the automatic frequency control system comes into picture. While if you look into the varector diode modulator, what we have learned, we know that the varector diode modulator is more stable. This form of FM generation is more stable compared to the other reactance modulator because varector diode modulator uses the crystal oscillator as its master oscillator. So there you find that the oscillations or the FM output is more stable. But again, we find that you have a disadvantage for this diode modulator. The reason being that since you use a crystal oscillator, the frequency deviation is very limited. So if you compare this reactance modulator and varector diode, we find that in many cases we need to use reactance modulator, but the disadvantage of reactance modulator instability is a concern for the transmitters. So this is where we use an automatic frequency control circuit along with a reactance modulator to make a stabilized reactance modulator. This is the block diagram of a typical transmitter AFC system. So here you can see that you have here a master oscillator. Now this master oscillator is going to be an LC oscillator because you're using a reactance modulator over here. So this master oscillator generates a carrier frequency. Now the reactance modulator is connected to this master oscillator. We have already learned this in the last class. So according to the input variations in the modulating signal, we find that the frequency of oscillation over here changes, and that is what we obtain as the FM output. So over here you find that there is a buffer circuit. This buffer is just to isolate your master oscillator from the remaining part of the circuit so that this frequency of oscillations are not disturbed. Now here you have a frequency limiter, sorry, an amplitude limiter. We know that in FM modulators, you can afford to keep amplitude limiters because you do not have any information contained in the amplitudes. So this is the FM generation by using a reactance modulator and master oscillator. So now we are going into this AFC system or the AFC section which we have added to this particular modulator circuit. So what we know is that when we use an LC oscillator, there are chances that the carrier frequency may drift. That is, sometimes it may become larger than what we have fixed, sometimes it may become lesser. So this frequency deviations or drifts, the reason for that is because the values of the components what we use, the LC, may vary with temperature or with time. So what we do there to correct this drift is your automatic frequency control circuit. So here what we have is we have here a crystal oscillator. In the AFC part, we have a crystal oscillator. A crystal oscillator is known to generate constant frequency of stable output frequency. So if you can design a crystal oscillator which produces a fixed output, and then this crystal oscillator output is supposed to be stable. So what we do over here is, we have here a mixer which has got two inputs. One input is the input from the crystal oscillator. So we are going to generate the same oscillations or the frequency as generated by the master oscillator over here. The crystal oscillator generates the same frequency. And from here, a part of this master oscillator, this FM output what you get, is given as the input to this mixer. Now we know what is the function of a mixer. The mixer can produce your sum and difference frequencies. Now what we are going to use here is the difference frequency. So here F1, what I've shown here is a small portion of fraction of the output taken from here. And F0 shown here is the output of the crystal oscillator. So this difference frequency is what is F1 minus F0. And this difference frequency will be something like 1 by 20th of the master oscillator frequency. That is what we want is, we want our oscillator to be working with the same frequency as the crystal oscillator, because we are trying to find out with this frequency difference, what we try to find out is, we are trying to find out if there is any frequency drift or shift happening in this master oscillator output. Now this output is fed through an IF amplifier which is tuned to this difference frequency. So this difference frequency is amplified by this IF amplifier and it goes to a discriminator. Now this circuit is responsible for producing a DC output voltage. Now the input to this circuit is to this input to this discriminator circuit is the difference frequency. So this difference frequency, depending on the master oscillator drift, sometimes we find that the difference frequency is increasing, sometimes we find that the difference frequency might decrease. But one thing we have to remember over here is, this is FM modulated output. So in FM modulated output, we know that the frequency keeps on varying according to the change in the modulating signal. This discriminator is so designed so that it does not respond to these rapid changes in the frequency, but instead it responds only to the small changes or the slow varying changes in the master oscillator frequency. So we have tuned this discriminator to this difference frequency of F1 minus F0, which is actually equal to the difference frequency between the accepted difference frequency between the crystal oscillator and the master oscillator. Now, if we find that the difference frequency which comes into this particular oscillator, into this discriminator, is above the set frequency for the discriminator, above the tuned frequency for the discriminator, or below the tuned frequency of the discriminator, we find that the discriminator gives us a DC voltage, and this DC voltage is what we call as the correcting voltage. So now what we have to see is, what happens, that is, what do we do with this DC voltage? So if you find that the master oscillator frequency is increasing, in that case you find that this difference frequency F1 minus F0 will increase. So that becomes greater than the frequency actually set for this discriminator, and it'll give us a positive DC voltage. Now, if you find that the master oscillator frequency F1 is decreasing, we find that this frequency difference decreases below the value set by the discriminator for the discriminator, and you can find that the output of the discriminator is going to be a negative DC voltage. Now this DC voltage is fed to the reactance modulator. Now this is how we're going to do the correction. That is what is happening over here. Let's just see over here. When the discriminator gives us a positive DC voltage as the output, you're feeding that to your reactance modulator. So we know that when the input voltage increases, we know that the transconductance of this reactance modulator, it'll increase. When transconductance increases, we know the expression for C. C is equal to GM into RC. So when GM increases, you find that the capacitance or C increases. And when C increases, we know that C and F are related. The frequency of oscillation is given by F equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. So when C increases, we find that the frequency is decreased. So this is how the frequency variation or the drift is controlled. So when the frequency, the master oscillator frequency tries to drift, it tries to increase, we see to it that the AFC circuit see to it that the frequency is try, that is, we try to reduce that increase in frequency, or we try to correct that drift. Now the same case when F1 minus F0, you find that F1 minus F0 is decreasing, or you find that the master oscillator frequency, it reduces below, it starts decreasing. Suppose it decreases or drifts in the opposite direction, what happens is that the discriminator gives us a negative DC voltage as the output. And when you have a negative DC voltage fed to the input of your reactance modulator, negative voltage fed to the input of reactance modulator, we find that the transconductance GM decreases. Now we know the expression for C, C is equal to GMRC, so C will reduce. If C reduces, we know how they are related with frequency of oscillation, and we find that the F increases. So this is how an AFC circuit or AFC system works in a transmitter. So this particular thing is very essential or very important as far as a reactance modulator is concerned, because when you are using LC oscillators as your master oscillators, or if you're using reactance modulator for generating FM, we know that we'll be using LC oscillators as master oscillators. So when you use LC oscillators as master oscillators, it is essential that we take care of the frequency drifts that are coming. So this AFC circuits are important, and this is how an automatic frequency control circuit works in order to correct the frequency drifts that occur in the master oscillators. Now, you have also learned, when we learned the varector diode, we have learned that varector diode can also be used for AFC system. So what you can do there is, instead of giving this correcting voltage to your reactance modulator, you can also give this correcting voltage to your varector diode, and you can place the varector diode in parallel to the tank circuit of the master oscillator, and thereby you can also correct the frequency drift that occurs in master oscillator. That's why we say you can use this AFC system along with the varector diode, and it can be used for correcting the frequency drifts in the master oscillator or LC oscillators. So that is all for today's lecture. So in today's lecture, we have seen the need for an automatic frequency control system, and we've explained the block diagram of a typical transmitter AFC system. Thank you.